Hello, everybody. Hello, and welcome back. This is Grazek, and I am playing The Walking Dead by Telltale Games. This is our fourth episode in this series, so if you haven't seen the others, spoiler alert, I guess. But at the end of our last, so this might get a little confusing here because I think we're going to use some cross terminology. But at the end of our last video, and maybe it's just easier if we get in here and get ready to play. If you were watching, we were playing the episode A New Day last time, and it was sort of the introduction where, introduction chapter, whatever you want to call it. So in the game, they call it episode one. Well, in our series, episode one takes place over episode one, two, and three. So, forgive me if we get a bit confusing here. So, at the end of the last episode, we finished A New Day. We are about to start Starved for Help. And we got a little sneak preview of the episode in the last one. It was sort of coming next, just like the television show would be. It's modeled on a television show type situation. So looks like there's going to be a lot of drama, human turning against human. Just like we did see in the television show itself. So I think without delay, let's check this out. You know, I like the graphics in this. You know, they're a bit wonky, but they're here we go. Previously.
I know who you are.
Oh, yeah. Few people do. I got another good one. Boom! Oh, that was great. This is where we finally begin our story back in episode one.
All by yourself through this?
Clem.
Yeah.
Clementine.
I want my parents to come home now.
And you keep an eye on that front
Kenny.
Door.
Kenny.
You're our lookout.
It's Doug.
Doug. Dead.
And I'm
Carly. Coming.
Okay, Carly, you'll shift in with Doug.
You got it, boss.
Ooh. Son of a bitch. Duck. I don't remember that guy's name, but it's a dick.
With the bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Nobody threatens my boy.
Kaboom. Yeah, tough times. There goes Doug.
Oh, my God.
Chose Carly.
But if anything happens to my daughter,
and this guy tried to kill us at the end, as we were escaping the drugstore, he tried to knock us out. Kenny came and saved us, though. Good Kenny. This game series adapts to the choices you make. The story is tailored to how you play. So, you know, twice now we've had choices. Ah, cool, here we go. It's just like the opening of a television show again, right? Lee, that's us. Three months later. Oh, that's a zombie. Choppity chop! Oh, it looks like a hard rocker. That was like me back when I was a teen.
Damn. What'd they get this time?
Looks like a rabbit.
Well, that's another meal lost.
Rabbit stew. Never had it.
All that my food in It seemed like so much at the time.
Maybe you shouldn't have opened the door.
Yeah, except then I'd probably be food by now. Trust me, I have no regrets.
Rabbit's hardly a meal, Mark, but...
Mark, I don't think we met Mark before.
No kidding. When I accidentally grabbed for Carly's rations the other night, I thought she was going to take off my hand.
We're all on edge. Just cut us some slack.
Yeah, you're right. I wish I knew for sure how much...
He looks like that dude from Independence Day.
We'll manage.
Maybe. You know, some people...
Cool, steady Lee.
Lily's handling rations.
Lily knows it's important to keep the adults fed and functioning. Sometimes that means someone's got to miss a meal.
You think Kenny's having any more luck than we are out here?
I sure hope so.
Yeah, between the lack of food and Kenny and Lily fighting all the time...
Lily must be Kenny's wife. I don't remember everybody's name.
Kenny's been talking about taking off if he can get that RV running.
RV.
Kenny won't abandon us.
I don't think he'll abandon us.
Yeah, I guess we'll see. Can't blame him, though. Did you hear Larry going off on him last night?
Oh, Larry's the dick. The old guy.
Seems like he's got a problem with you in particular.
I'm gonna get him. I am gonna get him.
He thinks I'm a danger to the group and Clementine.
I think he's the one putting us in danger.
See, my strategy is to be all like, I'm a good guy.
She's been skimming rations for him.
I don't know what he is. I'm not going to be he's the racist asshole.
He's a walking pile driver.
Because although that sounds right, it makes me sound like I'm emotionally looking for vengeance. Which I am. But I'm not letting them know. Ooh. The environment seems to be better in this episode. They didn't all come out at once, like, you know what I mean? Like, they came...
It's a long shot. I'd hate to waste the bullets.
We need the food.
If I don't think I can hit it, I won't shoot.
Like, it didn't... It wasn't just like, here's this game. I'm pretty sure the way it came out...
Shit! Was that Kenny?
I don't know. Come on!
Trouble. I mean, they look way better than they did in episode one, right? Like, I'm not going crazy here, right? This. All right, let's take.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, shit. No, no. Please don't kill us. We just want to help our teacher. We'll leave, I swear.
Lee, you guys okay?
Get it off. Get it off. God damn it. Get it off me.
Travis, maybe they can help.
These might be the same guys that raided our camp, and we barely got away from
all
that.
All right, let's just play
guys?
Cool.
Why the fuck is there a bear trap out here?
We're not gonna...
It's okay. We're not gonna hurt you.
Don't listen to them, Ben. Please, just let us go. We're not a threat to you.
Kid, chill out. We'll try to help you, but you gotta shut the fuck up.
Lee, this is fucked up. We've gotta help you. Please.
Ben, shut up. My dad was Special Forces. I know what I'm doing.
Just see if we can get him out. After that, you can leave us or whatever. I don't care. Please.
We gotta get him out of there.
Oh, God, thank you.
Fine, but you gotta hurry.
I don't know. This could be a trap,
hurry,
but...
Please, hurry.
But it's a pretty fucked up one.
The trap has been altered. There's no release latch.
Oh no.
There we go.
Shit! Walkers! It's now or never, Lee.
Please! Get me out of this!
Mark, get the boys back! Kenny, keep those walkers off of me!
Oh man, oh man.
No, Lee, do
something! Please! Please hurry!
Stop, stop, stop! Try to cut the chain!
Why is this happening to us? Oh God! Please save him!
Hurry! Let's go!
There has to be a way out of this!
Why would somebody do this?
Get, we use chain like that at the airport space to lift orders. He's all soaked
already! This is insane!
Hurry up.
has to be now!
I'm gonna take off his leg, I think.
Oh, damn it, Legion! Cut off his fucking leg!
No, no, no!
We don't have time for that!
I'm sorry.
Huh.
We have to go!
Oh, doesn't even go through! Ouch!
Lee, I can't keep him back forever!
Oh, he's got nailies! Another one!
Fuck, I'm just wasting ammo now! We gotta go!
Oh god, there's so many of them!
Ow! Oh! That is crazy! Oh, yes! Oh!
Oh god! Shit. Is he?
He passed out.
Oh man. That's intense.
If he's alive, grab him and let's go.
Behind you!
Travis!
Come on, we gotta move!
Oh, I gotta save this kid if I can. I can't. Well, welcome to episode 2. So yeah, as I was saying, it's not all... Oh, achievement! Going hungry. Dealt with a stranger caught in a bear trap. Sorry, kid. Oh, look at our motel. It's kind of long. We got it fortified quite nicely here. So as I was saying, it didn't all come out at once. It wasn't like, here's the disc. I mean, it was on Xbox, I think, but maybe not even. But, I think the way it worked on at least the iPad was, like, episode 1 came out, and I think it was free. Then this one can't come out sometime later, and it's like $5 or whatever. You know what I mean? If you want to continue the story, and you paid $5 or whatever for each episode, and then at the end, they released a disc for it, right? So, I mean, it could have been... Oh, something's up. Who's in the bushes? Who's in the bushes? It's not a bad little fort they got going here. It ain't gonna deal with humans, but it's great for zombies.
Get the gates open!
It's us!
Shit! What the hell are they doing?
Oh, that's Lily. Oh, it's not, Lily's the daughter of, Larry, the asshole.
What's going on?
I don't have time to explain.
Lee, are you okay?
Get him into the truck. I'll see what I can do.
Cat, okay? Can you fix him?
Jesus, Ken!
Lee!
I don't know!
Lee! What the hell? You can't just be bringing new people here. What are you thinking?
Hey, you want to calm down for a fucking minute?
Watch your mouth. No, I don't. I want to know why you thought bringing more mouths to feed was a good idea.
He would have died if we left him.
So what?
We are not responsible for every struggling survivor we come across. We have to focus on our group right here, right now.
Well, hang on. We haven't even talked to these people yet. Maybe they can be helpful.
Come on, Lily. These are people. People trying to survive just like us. We've got to stick together to survive.
The only reason you're here is because you had food. Enough for all of us. But that food is almost gone. We've got maybe a week's worth left. And I don't suppose you guys are carrying any groceries, are you?
No.
You guys fight it out then. Welcome to the family, kid.
Come over here and see what I drew.
What? No, I...
Just come on, okay?
You like to think you're the leader of this little group, but we can make our own goddamn decisions.
How does Lily become the leader?
This isn't your own personal dictatorship.
Oh, come on. You're being dramatic. Everything always turns into a power struggle between you two. I'm not going to be a part of that.
Hey, I didn't ask to lead this group. Everyone was happy to have me distributing the food when there was enough to go around. But now that it's running out, suddenly I'm a goddamn Nazi.
It doesn't matter who's in charge. Those people are here now. I guess we just have to decide what happens next.
No, Lee, it does matter. One person can't be in charge of everything. You know, it might feel safe for you to sit on the fence, but sooner or later, you're gonna have to decide whose side you're on.
I mean, obviously, when Kenny saw
it. I don't see any of you stepping up to make the hard decisions. My girl's got more balls than all of you combined.
Dad, please.
Larry, I'm going to kill you, bud. I am going to kill you.
You think this is easy for me?
So yeah, because the way it lags, they could have improved and tweaked the graphics. It's still the same style. I mean, look at that RV. That's great, right? It's comic booky as can be. But the characters look better. And like when we were running through the woods there.
Good luck.
Oh, she's giving me some job to do and I wasn't paying enough attention. Because I was waxing poetic about the graphics. Maybe they're exactly the same and I'm losing it. Cheese and crackers. What am I doing here? Oh, maybe she's saying I'm in charge. What's everybody so bummed about? Damn it. I feel like I missed a critical piece of this. Catch him.
It'll be okay.
I don't know. Can you give me a hand real quick?
Sure.
What do you need?
Just apply some pressure here while I try to close this up. You know, I thought I was starting to get used to this, sewing up people's injuries. But I mean, cuts and bruises are one thing, but Lee, this man has no leg.
I did the right thing.
Yeah, I know you did. The right thing is just scary sometimes, I guess.
It's,
Well, you've done all you can, Lee. Thanks for the help. Go ahead and check in on the others.
No problem. It was like two buttons on the controller and I had to push down or something. Alright, well, we talked to Katja. Soup cans, I guess. Soccer ball.
At least the kids have something to keep them occupied.
Look at the wall.
It keeps the walkers out. Carly's been doing the bulk of the lookout duty.
Will you hold the damn board steady?
Damn it, I got close to Larry.
I didn't realize I was getting this weak already.
What do you want? A handout? Oh, I got 60 cents in my pocket, if you'll shut up and quit being such a pansy.
Man, I hate Larry. I give him food.
Here, eat something.
I'm gonna give him the jerky.
Thanks, Lee.
Need any help with the wall?
Nope.
Actually, we could use your axe. You mind if we take it?
Yeah, give us that thing for a bit.
Well, I'm obviously not ever giving it to Larry.
Yeah, Mark, this should help.
Thanks.
Hey, I'm the one doing all the work over
here. Yeah, I'm sure you are.
You give me the axe?
Heart man.
Come on, Larry, give it a rest. I'm sure Lee is getting pretty sick of you thinking he's a danger to the group.
Is that what you told him?
Yeah, that's right.
And what are you going to do about it?
Look, I don't care what it is, but you two have got to start trying to get along.
The only thing I have to do is protect my daughter.
So he was going to say whatever I said, so.
So I would appreciate it if you two would shut up and let me get back to work.
I'm going to get you, Larry. Ugh, it's going to be great. You're going to go. There's going to be a point, perhaps. Where maybe, that would be delicious, but I'm just going to, whatever.
You've got to talk to Lily about getting
along. This isn't going to help.
Lily can make her own friends.
It's not about making friends. We're all in this together.
Yeah, that's
we
right.
We gotta start acting like it.
Stuff all that. We'd be fine without you.
All right.
Keep up on that fence.
Don't tell me what to do.
what a absolute jerk. Oh, the kids' table.
How are you doing, Clementine?
Okay.
Where's
your... Okay.
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sure. When did you lose it?
What am I looking for?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If I find it, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
Okay, Clem. I've got to take care of some things. Why don't you go back to playing with Duck for a while?
Okay.
Alright, let's talk to this guy.
Hey, is my friend gonna make it?
I don't know, but Kaja will do her best. I promise.
I can't believe you chopped off his leg.
There was no other way. How you holding up, kid?
I keep wondering if I could have done something to help, you know? Some kind of... I don't know. Something.
Yeah.
I'm sure you did all you could.
Yeah, maybe.
Want something to eat? Here, Ben.
Apple.
After what you've been through, seems like you could use a pick-me-up.
Seriously? I know food's scarce. This is really... I really appreciate it, man.
Are you out of your mind? We needed that food for us, for our kids.
Just because we don't know him doesn't mean he's not hungry.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to cause trouble.
You're fine, kid. Enjoy it.
Kind of wanted to, I'm gonna talk to Carly here.
Sleeping any better?
No. I know we should be grateful for beds.
She told me to give out the
no,
food.
I'm not.
Drugstore?
Yeah.
Lily has me handing out the food.
Ugh. That can't be an easy job.
It's not. I won't be able to feed everyone. What should I do?
Well, if you wanted to get in good with Lily, I'd make sure Larry gets some food. Even though that guy can be a real dick
sometimes. Yeah, he's not getting nothing.
On the other hand, giving that food to Kenny and his family might make him remember you if he decides to take off in that RV one day.
Yeah.
What about you? You need food too.
We all need food. I can't tell you what to do, but whatever happens, I know you'll be trying to do the right thing.
Thanks, Carly.
Good. Carly's not getting any food.
Back in a bit.
Right now, I'll give it to Kenny. I give some cheese and crackers to Kenny. That was my plan, anyway.
Want something to eat? Here, Kenny, take this.
How about my boy? He eat yet?
No.
Come talk to me once my boy's taken care of.
All right.
Hey, Doc, how about a little food? Here.
Yeah! Oh, man, I'm so hungry!
Some of these people have gone longer than me without food. They're the ones that need it.
We'll give it to Carly then.
Want something to eat? Here.
Me? How about you? You look like crap, Lee. When was the last time you ate?
Yeah.
Okay.
I want you to have
energy bars?
In case you or Clementine starts feeling weak. I know I said it didn't matter why you saved me instead of Doug, but...
You don't owe me anything, Carly.
I think maybe Katja. Since she's the doctor here.
Why don't you give it to Doc? I'm a little busy with your mess right now.
I already gave food to Doc.
I need space, Lee.
All right. Fine. Cranky. I don't... See, I'm trying to give it away so that I can get on to the next thing. I feel stuck here.
Here, Kenny. Take this.
How about my boy? He eat yet?
Yeah, I gave him something.
Sure, then hand it over. I'm starved. Thanks.
All right, you crank.
Not such an easy job, is it?
I hope I get to eat next time.
Oh, poor Clemmy.
I don't know how you have the strength to do this every day.
I don't have a choice.
Lee.
Kenny, I know I ran out of food before...
Hey, you took care of my boy. As far as I'm concerned, you did right by me. Still, I guess some people aren't going to be happy with your choices.
You're out! What happened to my food?
I ate it.
There's none left.
You keep treating people like this, and your days in this group are numbered.
You're one to talk, old man.
Yeah, well, I don't see you working on that wall.
Ken, Lee, come here, please.
Uh-oh, trouble over here.
Thank you, did he?
He lost too much blood.
God damn it. I'm getting sick of this shit.
Ken, come back. There's nothing...
Let him go, Kaja.
But...
Yeah. He just needs time. It's been a rough morning.
That man you brought, he tried, but he was never going to survive.
Well, at least he's not our problem anymore.
What about the other kid?
Oh my God! Oh. 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 Come on. Oh. Oh. Oh, he turned quick.
Thanks.
Why'd you bring him here in the first place, asshole?
Dad, calm down.
You're gonna get us all killed. Why didn't you tell us he was bitten?
What?
He was bitten, and you didn't say a goddamn word.
But he wasn't bitten, I swear.
Well, your not bitten friend here came back to life and tried to kill my wife.
What?
Wait, you all don't know?
What the hell are you talking about?
It's not the bite that does it. You come back no matter how you die. If you don't destroy the brain, that's just what happens. It's gonna happen to all of us.
Huh. No!
Lie.
No!
It's true. I swear it.
Maybe he's right. I didn't see any bites. It would explain why there's so many of them.
Jesus Christ. If you just die, and that's all it takes. And shit. One fatal car wreck in a family of five turns into a family of walkers.
Huh. When I first saw it happen, we were all hiding out in a gym, and everybody thought we were finally safe. But one of the girls, Jenny Pitcher, I think, I guess she couldn't take it. She took some pills. A lot of them. Someone went in the girls' room the next morning, and... God.
Back off!
Oh.
Whoa, lady, relax. Me and my brother, we just want to know if y'all can help us out.
I said back off!
Carly.
We don't want any trouble.
Of course, neither do we.
All right, more
I'm
people.
I'm Andy St. John. This here's my brother Dan.
Oh, Andy St. John.
We're just out looking for gasoline.
He was in the preview.
Looks like you folks got the motel locked down, which is fine, but if you could spare any gas, well, we'd be much obliged.
We've got no gas, Andy St. John.
Why do you need gas?
Our place is protected by an electric fence. Generators provide the electricity.
Our generators run on gas. Look, we own a dairy farm a few miles up the road. If y'all be willing to lower your guns, we can talk about some kind of trade.
What the?
How y'all doing on food? We got plenty at the dairy.
Lee, why don't you and Mark check the place out? See if it's legit. I'm going with you. I got your back if anything seems fishy.
So, what are y'all thinking?
You've got a deal. We'll bring some gas to your dairy. In exchange, you give us some food to bring back. We'll see how it goes from there.
Sounds fair. A couple gallons should power one of our generators for a while.
All right.
So, this dairy, you guys really have food?
Sure do. We lost most of the cattle, but we still have lots of milk, butter, and cheese stocked up.
And with the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
It's nice to get away from that motel for a while. This Lily King thing is starting to get ridiculous. Personally, I'd be happier if you started to take charge more.
Kenny keeps us motivated. He believes
I don't
hope
want to take charge. I want everybody to think that I'm that. Just
or
here.
Or maybe you just don't want to be in charge.
Well, not everyone thinks I'm so trustworthy.
I really
because of your past.
Control it all from behind.
Does anyone else know?
Larry knows.
Great. That can't be.
Clementine knows. She was there when we were talking in the drugstore and asked me about it. I couldn't lie to her.
What exactly did happen with the senator?
You know what happened.
I only know what the press was told. I don't know your story.
Sometimes I wonder if I should talk to the group about it.
You don't have to. Whatever happened before things went to hell doesn't matter anymore.
Sure it would be good because it that way. Then it would take right. power That's away from somewhere, some from Larry.
Some messed up shit. I've seen situations like yours 100 times. It doesn't have to make you a bad man.
I really appreciate that.
I mean, thank God Lee showed up when he did. Right, Lee?
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself, Lee?
Where are you from?
I grew up in Macon.
Right here in the heart of Georgia. That's what I like to hear. Y'all seem pretty settled in at that motor inn. Who's running things over there?
Oh, that's right. This isn't the group.
Lily. She runs a pretty tight ship. Her and her dad are ex-military.
Yeah, she knows her shit, but she needs to know when to back off sometimes.
How many people you got over there anyway?
A lot of questions.
Well, the kid here is our newest arrival, but we're all looking forward to some food.
Well, here's to helping each other out.
That's right.
Well, we'd love to get you all out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
These
in the
guys.
Summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great.
I don't
great.
Like this at
Everything
all.
Everything helps.
Mama's been running the dairy for well, as long as I can remember, but now it's
You
getting...
think you're going to cut me out of this?
Shit, get down.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
You and Gary are always pumping this shit.
Bandits.
Who?
Those look like the people who raided my camp.
Who are they?
Fuck you. You knew we were hungry. And you guys were keeping it up.
There's only two of
them.
Oh no, there's
Yeah, and you know what?
More.
We ate it all. What are you gonna fucking do about it?
Don't worry. Danny and I got you covered if something happens. But let's just wait this out.
Yeah.
Fuck you!
The law of the jungle in full swing.
Come on, let's get to the dairy where it's safe.
I don't think this dairy is gonna be safe. It looks nice. All the better to catch you off guard.
Here it is, St. John Family Dairy. Y'all can see how we kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha. They fry like bugs in a zapper. Huh. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
Oh, that's only gonna last for so long.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
This is a really brilliant setup.
Suits us just fine.
This place looks untouched. You'd never know the rest of the world is in ruins.
It's worth protecting.
It is pretty nice. All the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Guys, this is our mama.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He's from Macon.
A couple of our old farmhands were from Macon. They grow them good there.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh, my goodness. That place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival experience to lead your group?
Oh, wow.
We all work together. Plus, we've got plenty of people with military experience.
Well, that's good to hear. That motel ain't the safest place.
I don't
I thought you said someone else was running things.
Oh, yeah. I thought she was asking about survival tactics.
Well, it don't matter. You're here now. We'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
Thanks for having us. We brought some gasoline on good faith.
We're all incredibly hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Can't get stuff like that anymore. Not without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
Drugs.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
I'm going to be keeping my eye out for the autosave.
We could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet? Oh, my. Our prayers have been answered.
Maybe our whole group could come for the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls. It'll be nice to have some folks to help out around here again. Danny, why don't you come help me out in the kitchen?
This is bad.
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip over here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
I can handle myself.
Take
what are we
this.
Gonna do?
Why don't you go ahead and take Ben along anyway?
Take care of yourself, Lee.
What?
See you in a while.
Maybe I got the handgun now.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm going to go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. Yeah. It's got food. And that fence.
Good to be true.
If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay. So how do you want to play this?
Let's make sure this place is safe.
Before we can think about bringing our whole group here to stay, we need to figure out if this place is as safe as they're telling us.
Right. Obviously, they think it's safe. But is it safe enough for the kids? I noticed a broken swing over there. Not a big deal, but maybe there's other things not working that we just can't see yet.
And checking the fence perimeter?
I'm not worried about a freaking broken swing, dude. I'm worried about a human cutting operation in the barn where they chop you up and feed you to Mama St. John. Oh, I didn't notice if there was a autosave there. Alright, I'm not going that way. I'm gonna wander around here. Let's take a look at our broken swing.
Too bad it's broken. I'll bet Clementine and Duck would have loved something like this to play on.
I'm sure
kids
they would.
Kids used to like that old swing even more than the tour sometimes.
I'll bet. How'd it break?
Got busted the first day those things showed up. Thank God no one was on it at the time.
Looks like it just needs a new board for the
seat. Looks like blood to me.
Make it safe for Clem and Duck. And let the St. Johns know we can pull our weight around here.
Right. Continue to under the perimeter. Let's take a look.
You can definitely tell they built this thing themselves.
I'm looking for the autosave.
What's that?
Generator. You guys come along with gas just in time. Hey, don't mess with that, okay? The thing's a little tricky, and I don't want to spend half a day trying to fix it again.
As soon as we hit an autosave here, I'm going to end this video.
I'm glad you guys decided to help us out. I noticed back at the motel that you folks are pretty well armed. You've been stockpiling, huh?
Questions.
Yeah, if you need some extra people to protect the dairy, count on us.
Well, hopefully it'll never come to that, but thanks.
Let's go fix the perimeter
now. Oh, good. The fence will stop a walker in about 3 or 4 seconds, but it's overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
Yeah. You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
Well, that'd be great.
I'll turn off
the northwest section, and if you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points, well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive. You never know.
I am definitely going to stay attentive. Going for a walk with Mark.
So how's the place looking? Is it safe enough for us to stay? If we can?
It's pretty amazing what they've done with this dairy, but let's see what it takes to secure this fence before drawing any conclusions.
I can't wait until everyone's out here. Everyone besides Larry.
What are you telling him what I said about him thinking I'm dangerous?
Look, you said it. You even admitted it right to him.
I try to be civil, at least.
He's too busy being cranky to notice.
There's one.
Ugh.
An arrow.
Lee, it's dead.
Come on, let's push it off.
All right.
Looks like he's stuck.
Give it a go.
Looks like he's stuck.
This arrow.
Disgusting.
Push him off now.
Come on. I'm sure there's still a few more.
Once this fence is patched up, this place will be a fortress. God, can you imagine not having to worry about the walkers anymore?
A fortress needs people to defend it.
Mm-hmm.
We've got enough people. So what's your take on the brothers? They seem to have this place tied down pretty well.
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. They seem decent enough. I just want you to know that I've got your back if anything goes down.
Yeah, that's good, because...
Thanks. There's another one.
I see it.
Oh, we got a fence problem here. Get off!
You never get used to the smell, do you?
Nope.
Oh, we're not gonna fix this fence?
Christ. I can't stop thinking about dinner. Thanks for the rations earlier. It's not easy eating in front of the kids, but... it's all that's keeping me on my feet right now.
Just try to focus on the task.
I knew what they were doing, teasing us with food and then giving us chores.
Having a good meal will be worth it.
If it's not poison.
Come on, I think I see where they're getting in. This one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good.
It'd be a pretty sweet gig.
Let me get this thing back in place so we can get Mr. Crispy off of here.
I think we'd get better leverage from the other side.
Good idea.
That's bad news.
Little help here, Lee?
What was I gonna say? It would be a pretty sweet locale. And maybe
Holy
these people.
What just happened?
The fences are on.
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here.
Oh!
What the hell? Get to the gate!
What is going on here?
Fuck! Now what?
With the fence on, that gate is our only way out!
Can't hide forever!
Wow!
We had an agreement! Now you're fucked!
Come on!
Get closer!
This ain't gonna work.
Shit!
Alright.
You really think you can fuck with us?
Get down!
The blades are stuck in the dirt.
And get this.
I see
you. Oh, look at that. Get this out of here.
Give us the food.
They're looking for food. All right, we need to get this tractor out. So there's obviously some kind of deal that they've reneged on. Which is a little annoying.
Lee, get back here.
What are we gonna do? I feel like I'm missing something. Really obvious here.
Get out of the open.
Now there you are, boy.
Whoop. Alright, let's look around. Oh. No, that's the
They'll see you.
Where's our food?
Come on. Ooh!
Come on. If we can reach the gate, we can get through this fence and back to the house.
Ah!
They're on the
shit,
that hurts. You assholes deserve to die!
Ooh. Ooh. Come on, boys. Come on.
Oh.
What happened?
Shit. One of the dead we pushed down earlier. I'm gonna have to move him.
Come on. So, apparently, the danger here might not be our
another one? How many of
our hosts,
we pushed down?
But rather the people that they're screwing over. Oh, this one's alive! Ah! Ah! This is ugly! Oh!
Ah! You okay?
Yeah. Fair.
Come on.
Oh no! He's coming behind us! They accidentally off the post there.
Let's get out.
Alright. To the gate.
You lucky sons of bitches! Go ahead and run! We ain't going nowhere!
Alright, so there's our autosave.
What's wrong?
fence came on. Some people started attacking from the woods, and we got trapped between them and the fence.
Holy shit, are you okay?
I heard Mark yelling. Thought y'all were giving me the all clear. Man, I am real sorry.
Oh, my Lord! What happened to you, sweetheart?
It was those bastards in the woods, Mama.
Yeah, I'll be all right once it's out. But God damn, it hurts.
Hey, y'all.
Mark, oh my God, what happened?
You got shot with an arrow.
Christ, are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I should just...
I look on Larry's face.
Oh no, honey, come on, Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out.
Well, maybe they're not cannibals.
What kind of shit is this?
We ran into some people on the way up here. Bandits, I guess. I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning. Killed a bunch of our farmhands. We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
You knew about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
God damn it. Carly said this place was locked down tight.
Maybe it isn't as safe here as we thought.
Look, we're sorry. We never had them screw with us like this. Not since we started giving them food. Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know where these assholes are?
They're hard to pin down, but I think I know where at least one of their camps are. When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
Bandits. Alright, so that's...
Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows.
We'll see.
What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo. These are nice people. Let's not do anything to get us thrown out.
Larry's the voice of reason. Are you kidding me?
Deal with these bandits. You guys should try to make friends with Andy and Brenda while I'm gone.
Oh,
well,
man.
That's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah, that's real charming.
Where's Ben and Carly?
Since Carly and Ben ate some of the food on the way to get us, she volunteered to stay behind and watch the motor in until we get back.
Interesting.
Hey, I remember seeing kids in your group, so I went ahead and fixed that swing while you were out. I hope you kids like swings.
A swing. I love swings. Just like at my treehouse. Come on, Doc.
Why don't you kids go and play on the swing, huh?
Well, maybe this will be a good deal for us.
We're looking out for you.
So, I don't see an autosave, so we may have to go through this again. Alright, well. So that is the first part of episode 2, according to the game. It is the end of our fourth episode. Perhaps this farm is safe and my paranoia is unjustified, but, you know, Walking Dead, I mean, paranoia is pretty much baked into the formula, isn't it? Anyway, guys. I had some fun in this episode. A good mix of paranoia and terror, and I hope you enjoyed watching as much as I enjoyed making it. Please, if you did like the video, hit like. Don't forget to subscribe. That way, that you can stay up to date. That'll be on the screen now. For now, this is Grazek, signing out. Thank you.